Hey guys, Arrox here for Arrox, and I just thought of a quick series this morning when I was on my way to school. Sorry for any background noise. My sister has a friend over, it's quite annoying. And so basically the series is basically just something to do once a week or once every other week. And I'm just gonna be talking about stuff going on in RS or recent updates and other stuff. I might rant as well a bit during this. And so yeah. By the way, guys, I'd just like to quickly state how this series is kind of meant for you to listen to while you play Scape or Runescape or whatever, and I don't really expect you to want to watch the video, but it's kind of just, I just put me training prayer over it since I didn't really want you guys looking at a black screen just in case you watched it, and so you can see how I train prayer. Fun! And so, my first topic for this video, I want to discuss the new Polypore dungeon, and which came out like a week ago. Yeah, a week and a day from now, I believe. This may be uploaded later. And so it came out, and I think it was a really good update. All the gear is good and stuff. But one thing Jagex got horribly wrong, I think, is the prices of the gear. I seriously think they should have done this much better. The release prices were absolutely crazy. I think the Polypore staff release price was like 8 mil. Like, what are Jagex thinking when it costs like a mil, or not even a mil, like a few hundred K to recharge? They think it's going to stay at that price, or charge, or whatever. And the Polypore stick isn't that rare of a drop, as I've heard, since I've been seeing videos and stuff of people commonly getting it. I wouldn't know for myself, though, since I do not have the 95 Slayer to kill the monster, or whatever. And then the Grifflike armor, or not the Grifflike, the armor, though, oh my god. Like, it's good and all, but like, it degrades so quickly. It's like the PvP armor, it drives me crazy. Then Jagex released such high prices when they probably should have known it's not gonna stay that high. And they could have made it so much easier to fix. Like, even just release like a new rune for which you charge the Polypore staff with or something, instead of using fire runes or make Polypore sticks more rare, make the flakes harder to get or less quantity drops. Because honestly, I lost a good portion of my bank on the day of release. I wanted to see the armor and stuff, and I was going to make a video, but then I quickly tried to sell them because I was going to lose a lot of money. I already lost like 3 mil because of those, no, not even 3 mil, like 5 mil, which is quite a big bit of my bank since I only had like a 20 mil bank around the time. And yeah, that's my ideas on the Polypore dungeon. I seriously think Jagex could have done a better job with the prices and the drop rates and all, but besides that, next topic I'd like to talk about. I don't really have one picked. I remember I was going to talk about something. I'm going to pause the recording and check what my topic was. One sec. Okay, sorry about that quick kind of cut or whatever. My next topic is on just the whole removal of dicing and stuff. I know this is kind of old, but I just thought of the series and I thought I'd like to discuss this since I know a lot of people that made their money dicing. And myself, I used to dice, so I'm not gonna lie, I made the money for 92 prayers through dicing. And if I had the chance to do it again, I would not. But the problem I see with just the removal of dicing and how they want to completely remove gambling and stuff, I see this as a problem for many players because people buy ranks and dice clans for like billions of GP sometimes, and it's like, what happens when they remove dicing? They lose all of that, right? Unless like the clan chat owners are going to refund them or something. I think this can cause a big problem. And a lot of players might quit RuneScape, but at least like ranked players and dice fans. Another thing is, I think Jagex could have had a much better way of going around this, because I think the main reason they removed this is because so many people were getting scammed because of this. But Jagex could have easily removed the dice bag or disabled it, but made it like a mini game right at like the place where you teleport to Duel Arena and make like an extra house off to the side the other direction or whatever, where you could go in and you could like state guys almost, and you'd roll the dice and stuff, but then you wouldn't have like a host or whatever. You just kind of put it like, and I don't even know, but it could be like a mini game, which would have been so much better, and I think would have been good since a lot of people might just go there to have fun even because it's pretty much the same thing as staking. So in my opinion, if you're gonna remove dicing and jamming, say it's bad, then you might as well just remove like staking or something, which I think is completely unreasonable, and they should just turn it into a mini game, which would be a much better option. Besides that, I don't think there's much else I'd like to talk about for dicing. I think not really, but one more thing: the Jagex's attempts to remove dicing were just a total fail. Like, I know they started that toy horsey thing. I myself don't gamble or stake or whatever anymore. I kind of stopped after I got the money for 92 prayer. Yeah, that's all I wanted to talk about for dicing. And now on to my third topic, which may end up being last, depending on how long this video is and how long this clip of me trading prayer lasts. So that is on the new money bag, I think it's called, or money pouch, whatever, the tool belt, which came out today. In my opinion, good, brilliant update. I love the money bag. Aside from the little glitch where you just ran exchange in the corner, it says you have no coins. If they could just fix that, it'd be really good, because, and I'm pretty sure if you die with coins now, you protect them, but it's just a great way to save an inventory slot, especially, and I don't know, I just really like the idea of having a money bag. But the tool belt, oh my god, tool belt, phenomenal. Aside from the fact you can only have, like, bronze tools, it's amazing, like, you could do smithing with no hammer or whatever. I'm not sure of this certain, but I'm pretty sure you can go to Pandos using the hammer. So that saves you an inventory spot right there. It's also good because I'm pretty sure you can't lose anything from it when you die. It's pretty good update. I don't think there's any flaws in it besides the little glitch I sent in you. And really cool is now when you right click the money bag, you can click price check right there, which is really quick instead of going into the armor stuff and stuff really quick if you want to quickly price check a drop or something and you're going for like an efficient kill or whatever. And yeah, it's pretty cool. And I don't know, that's pretty much it about the money bag and that, and I think that's all of my topics there. This video may be longer if I do have another topic, so let me pause and think of one. Yeah. Okay guys, so I just got my final topic, and it's kind of broad. It's just generally about how PVM and just PvP and the combat is getting kind of simple, especially like, imagine, like, with the new Ganodermic gear, it's just crazily kind, it's pretty overpowered. And, like, imagine just some guy in Claymores with, like, full Ganodermic and, like, a Divine and a Staff of Light, a special or whatever. Is it even, and imagine they had, like, prayer on. Is it possible to do damage to them? Like, you could probably be, like, max strength and claw spectrum and nothing would happen. It's just crazy. And then the whole Ganodermic thing, it's just, it kind of is overpowered, like, and then in, there I feel bearing a T-bone, and it's like, I've heard people getting, like, 10 plus kills in Corbius, I don't know if this is true, but I've heard about it, and it's like, oh my god, I remember when it came out, people were, like, impressed if you could get one kill, like, a five-man team, and it's just crazy, and, like, it's just so... just insane. And then PvP, even like people can have like full Torva defense and like kind of Torva defense and like I guess Carol's defense or whatever it's called, or I don't know the Ganodermic stats, honestly. Maybe it's around the Pernix mage defense stuff, but it's just crazy. It's like they're almost like invincible. And then Jagex thinks, so, oh, we can just make it really not good because we'll make it only last 2 hours and you have to recharge it. But honestly, only the rich people do use this stuff. And now it's coming to like, if you don't have money for the best gear, you're at such a big disadvantage. It's almost, it's insane. And that's pretty much my first, like, end of my topic. Just about how it's all getting kind of overpowered with gear and stuff, and Jagex needs to do something to start making it balanced for the less rich players or whatever. And yeah, And that was my first episode, I guess, an installment of Runescape Rambles. And thanks for watching, guys. And yeah.